This channel is proudly sponsored by Earascapes. Check out the Patreon for audio dramas, free previews and exclusive tiers featuring music, content creation and all things related to professional creativity. You will find the link in the description and in the pinned comment. Hi, welcome to this part of my review featuring Hexen Academy. If you haven't seen the other parts of my review, featuring this tabletop RPG where you learn magic as you survive the intrigues of a fragile piece, please check out the playlist in the description below. This time we are going to talk about incantations. These are pre-written spells that combine 2 to 4 tag actions together into a sequence without having to roll. The more tags you use, the higher its cost and cooldown becomes, which is always total tags used minus 1 for both. An incantation's cost determines how many stuns must be spent to perform it. Incantations require no rolls to perform. Cooldown determines how long it takes an incantation to refresh itself before it can be performed again. You cannot perform an incantation if you took damage during the previous round, unless you use a wand. When it comes to learning new tags, this is similar to crafting an item, only you'd make study rolls using whatever trait tag you are trying to learn. Some tags will be harder to learn than others based on its affinity towards your homeland. You always have a positive affinity towards a tag from your region of origin, but will always have negative affinity towards a tag from your region's antipode or opposite, while all other regions will have a neutral affinity towards you. When it comes to learning or creating new incantations, similarly to learning new tags, you make study rolls. Only you would use each tag involved in the incantation until you accrue enough steps of progress to create it. Of course, the more tags you use, the longer it'll take to create. You may also add tags to an existing incantation that you created, but you'll need to use Manipulation Revise to do so. You can also teach incantations to others. In order to teach someone a tag, you must first be proficient in the tag, or have learned or created the incantation that they are trying to learn. Then you must roll Charisma Command. Apart from that, it's important to note that there are three items related to incantations. First, we have scrolls. A scroll, obviously, is a one-use item which resembles a sheet of parchment paper, typically rolled up and bound using a ribbon or a cylindrical box, which seals the scroll until the user is ready to use it. Scrolls allow you to activate the effects of incantations. Then we have grimoires. A grimoire is a magical tool which functions similarly to a scroll, except that instead of being a one-use item that erases itself once it's used, it's a tome which holds an indefinite number of pages, which automatically stores any incantations that you've learned inside of it, so that its cost or cooldown can be altered by spending charges from your wand. And then we have wands, certainly. Wands are magical tools which resemble pistols with octagonal barrels. A wand is designed to draw in miasma and store it within itself for later use, so that its user is able to utilize their incantations more effectively and consistently. And this concludes this part of the review. In the next part, we are going to talk about academic nuances such as time slots, clubs, downtime actions, and many other things. When it comes to this incantation process, it's very simple to understand. But it does contain significant depth when it comes to playing around with these incantation tags. Now, when it comes to the objects, they are pretty standard when it comes to magical operations in other tabletop RPGs, with the exception of wands. I think it is great that they resemble pistols with octagonal barrels. Thank you for watching this part of the review. Don't forget to leave a like, a comment, and subscribe. And thank you so much to those of you that are going the extra mile to support the channel. If anyone else wishes to further support the channel through PayPal or DriveThruRPG, the information will be in the description and in the pinned comment. This has been Abraham El Jaguar, a professional game master. If you want me to run a game for you, please check out the pinned comment as well. And remember, roleplay solves everything. Once again, thank you and see you later.